Hi!
I'm Jen.
I'm Corey.
And we are Corey and Jen.
Do stuff!
Thank you for being here. Welcome to our channel. We are Corey and Jen, and we like to do stuff. And share it with you.
What do we do?
Welcome to our channel. Like and subscribe. And
smash the bell!
Smash the bell, please. Pretty please. Okay, what are we talking about today, babe?
Disneyland Part 2.
Excuse me?
Disney World.
That was the worst slip of the tongue ever.
Disney World Part 2.
That's better. Yes, so if you watched our Part 1, we talked a little bit about our first day, and we only have 2 days, so it should be nice, short, and sweet. We got up early. I had scheduled an Uber from our hotel to Magic Kingdom, and then I read, or I saw on somebody's YouTube, on another creator's channel, that they have to drop you off at a transportation station if you've never been to Disney World. So Magic Kingdom's kind of like an island almost. So from the parking lot to where Magic Kingdom is, you have to cross a lake, Bay Lake, I think it is, by ferry. So if you take an Uber to Magic Kingdom, you get dropped off at that transportation station, and you also have to take the ferry across to get to Magic Kingdom. Well, on another creator's channel, they were giving out some tips, and they said, get dropped off at Disney's Contemporary Resort, and you can literally, 5-6 minutes, you're there. You walk down this little sidewalk, got our temperatures checked in this little tent, bunch of security, they didn't go through our stuff. They didn't want to touch anything. We did have to go through a metal detector. But they just asked us, do you have any weapons? Do you have this? Do you have that? And then the metal detector and our bag went through something too.
I think it went through an x-ray.
Like an x-ray thing. Mm-hmm. Just to make sure, you know, obviously can never be too sure. And I'm glad they do that. We got through there just fine. Literally 5-minute walk from Contemporary. And we were at the front gate. I had to look up my little, because we were only one day. I know some of you, this is my second time ever at Walt Disney World. I went when I was 14.
I went when I was like 8.
Yeah, I was 14 and I was a grouchy B.I. you know what. So
Family Channel.
I know, I'm just saying. My mom likes to give me so much crap about it. I was not happy to be there. You can see it in every family photo. It was hilarious. We were there in 1991.
Maybe I'll get Mary to give me a picture to post here of
She definitely
Jen.
Will. She's like, here, look at this. I was 14 and I thought Magic Kingdom is for babies. I didn't want to be there. I wanted to go to Epcot. That's why. So just FYI. Now that I'm older, I'm like, I want to go to Magic Kingdom.
Epcot?
Are you kidding me?
What's that?
Know. Although Epcot has the alcohol Family Channel. that's funny. I looked up my little email. If you go to Disney for multiple days and stay at a Disney resort, you get a little magic band. And you just literally put your wrist up. It lights up green and you walk in. Because we were there one day and we weren't staying on property. I had to look up my email reservation. She scanned it with her little thing, gave us a card, put the card against the little Mickey, and it turned green and we went in. It was kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
And I cried. Corey had to hug me. I saw the castle and I bawled. I was like, with our masks on.
Yeah.
I did. Well, I'm getting teary-eyed thinking about it now because it was amazing. I think after watching so many videos and loving Disney for so long and Watching the fireworks and everything in the castle is just the epitome of magic. And Cinderella is my favorite princess, and it's Cinderella's home. So, yeah. Like, I'm gonna cry. We got our pictures taken. We got yelled at.
I got yelled at.
I didn't see her. Corey did. But they have specific cast members that I want to say wear yellow, like a yellow vest or something, that all they do is go around and make sure you have your mask on. You are not allowed to take them off for photos, which we did, and we snuck it in. We'll let Corey show you. But she did notice, and she came over, and then Corey went to put his mask back on, and it broke, and she freaked out. The cast member freaked out a little and was like, do you need another one? You know, you need to put your mask on.
Like, oh, I got another one right here in my backpack. I'm just digging it out.
Like, calm down. Like, they're all about it. Yeah. They were sanitizing everywhere. Everything was the epitome of clean. But Disney usually is very clean anyway. They have people just picking up trash and everything. So, yeah, it was... that part was awesome. And I wasn't... Maybe it's just me, but I wasn't super worried about it because... I had remembered Disney being clean and watched videos of people saying, you know, that there's Disney didn't like to see that. Like, so that wasn't a thing. It wasn't an issue. So, yeah. So we walked down, got pictures in front of the castle, walked through the castle, and then we had to stop and decide where we wanted to go next. We're like, what ride do we want
to
go on?
And everyone always says, when you make a plan, you're never going to stick to your plan. And we had made a plan, and we didn't stick to our plan. Kind of. We started out.
It was really hard because of COVID, there was nobody there. Like,
and we got there at, so the rope drops at 8:30, right?
Yes, they start letting people in at 8:30. The park technically doesn't open till 9, so a lot of the rides aren't going until 9. We got there probably about 10 to 9.
Well, about 8:45. Yeah. And then they started announcing as we were walking through the castle that
the roller coasters were open and Haunted Mansion was...
Peter Pan and Small World were open. And we just happened to be right there. We're like, let's just hop on Peter Pan.
Right in front of Peter Pan. And it said, no wait. So we walked on.
Yeah.
We
hopped right on Peter Pan. And then we went right across to Small World. And
walked right on.
It was a longer walk getting down to the boats than it was that we had to wait when we got to the boats.
Yeah, literally. They ask you how many, and we walked on. We did like 4 rides in less than 45 minutes.
Oh, yeah, because then after we
walked on the Haunted Mansion.
Yeah, we did walk on the Haunted Mansion, and what was the...
The longest one?
Well, and then we went over to Splash Mountain.
That was a 20-minute wait. It said 40, but we only waited about 20 minutes.
A lot of the rides, too, were saying 40 to 50-minute wait, and they were half the time, except for Space Mountain was legit.
And the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, but we'll talk about that later.
Mm-hmm.
Space. We're a little sad. Oh, we can hear the rain. Hopefully Lincoln's okay.
So after Splash Mountain, we went over to
Big Thunder Mountain Railroad.
That was, I thought we kept getting closer and we just kept circling around, and a lot of the waits didn't even seem like they were 20-minute waits because Disney
social
likes
distance.
and Disney likes to put a lot of stuff in the line.
In the queues, yeah.
So there's stuff to look at, and I found myself looking at things going, oh, I wonder what that's like.
And I'm going, come on. Yeah, she's like, oh, come on, we gotta go.
Yeah. Everything moved very quickly.
Yeah, after that, it was kind of random. Like, we went to Pirates, which is in a different land. We went to Jungle Cruise.
Yep. And then we and decided then we wanted we some. We were going to do the Tiki Lounge.
That line was long.
And we decided we want some food. Please.
Here's another not so fun part. Right now, I think it's not. I think I know it's because of COVID. A lot of their stuff is closed. Food establishments. A lot of the food vendors. So if you've never been to Disney World, there's a lot of little carts. Like we saw a spring roll cart. We saw lots of popcorn and snack Disney snack carts that have like the Disney ice cream sandwich or the Mickey ice cream thing, whatever. So a lot of them were closed. We had the hardest time finding a place to eat. So I went on the app. So if you ever go, I'm not going to get into it right now, but the My Disney app and the Magic Guide, which has just the outline of the castle, is the app, what it looks like. And then the Disney World app. See if you guys can see it. So these two right here are literal lifesavers. So the Magic Guide, and obviously they're closed right now, but for any park, you can see the wait times. And normally it'll tell you. And I do have to tell you, so it's a free app. If you want the most updated and accessible areas of the app, like we use the map on there quite often.
If you pay, you get the enhanced map, right?
Yes, it's $7.99 a month.
But it puts your dot where you are in the map.
And tells you where restaurants are. Well, so it tells you where they are. It doesn't mean they're open. That's where we were having issues, is I was looking at the map and I'm like, yeah, it says it's there, but it's not open. So we were starting to get hangry. So we're like,
we get hangry a lot.
Well,
we didn't eat breakfast that morning either. Nope. Because we wanted to rope drop there. And our Uber driver was taking the longest way possible to get to our hotel.
Traffic was kind of, anyways, but, yeah, it was really difficult to find food. But again, on the app, if you go, I'm sorry, on the other one, on Disney World's app, you can mobile order food. And this is the only way you can eat without having reservations. Only way. Unless you find an open ice cream stand like we did way late in the day. But we did not make reservations because we wanted to ride rides all day, which was a mistake on our part.
We had originally planned on doing the Be Our Guest dinner
at 5:30.
And we wanted to...
Then we're like, bad reviews.
And we only really wanted one thing.
Very expensive. And it's a preset menu with very little to choose from. Yeah, and I wanted to go there for gray stuff. And that's dessert. And I was not going to pay the $63 a person plus tip on top of that. Yeah, I just was not doing it when we had park time. We wanted more park time. So I canceled those reservations. And so we were stuck trying to find a place to eat. We found Cosmic Rays over in Tomorrowland, which actually kind of worked out because we hadn't ridden any rides over there. So we went and sat. I mobile ordered. Another not so fun part, because there's so little options for dining, it was packed.
And Cosmic Rays has a lot of space in there.
And outside.
And outside. And it was packed to the brim.
We could not find a place to sit. We literally had to stand in one spot and wait for somebody to get up. And there's only two of us. Like, there were families of 9 and 10 that couldn't find a place either, and we're sitting outside on like the bricks eating.
I felt like a mafia hit guy or something. I'm just standing there staring people down that are just like,
are you getting up yet?
Yeah, those like,
ain't getting up yet.
Sitting there meddling around with their empty plates, like, are you gonna move?
Yeah. So we finally got to sit down and eat. Though I will say, I ordered just a foot-long hot dog, plain, and some fries. Did I get fries with mine? Yes, I did. Yes. I did not care for the fries, but I'm not a fry person.
A little overcooked.
At all, anyway. And Corey got a burger, a big burger. Like, that was a big burger. Well, there's lots of stuff.
The other burgers
look
bigger, but this one... I don't eat a lot of stuff. So.
He doesn't put a lot of stuff on his burger, so I guess to me it looked big, but I'm more of a snacker. Like, I probably would have been happy all day just getting some popcorn and snacking on popcorn. Didn't realize till we got there we could have brought food in. I would have done that.
Pirates of the Caribbean, when we were in line for that, there was a family sitting there just eating sandwiches.
Sandwiches and little bags of chips. I'm like, that's perfect.
Hit that little girl over the head and take her bologna sandwich.
At Disney. You believe this?
Well, it was like a family of seven. They would have taken me down easily.
Next time, some Cheez-Its and a couple sandwiches.
Yeah, some little snacks. Perfect.
But lunch was good and it wasn't that expensive. I think it was $27 for the two of us.
Roundabout. And we got some add-ons. Jen got Oogie Boogie's ice, and I'll put a picture of that somewhere.
Oh yeah, and Corey got an actual Jack Skellington cup.
It was like $15 for a drink that's a Jack Skellington cup, and I'm thinking just like a large cup with maybe Jack's head on it. This was an actual Jack Skellington doll. Posable.
He'll put a picture up.
And you can fit like a small amount of liquid in his body.
It's like an 8-ounce cup.
And then you suck out of his back. And so it was a sippy cup. I'm like, okay.
It's cool, though.
It was worth the $15 for a soda. Yeah.
I think it's something where I'll probably put like a 3M hook on it and hang it up. Because it's like...
Or it could sit on a shelf easily. On a shelf, yeah. Easily.
It's so cool. And then Oogie Boogie's ice, it's like just two blocks with lights in them with Oogie Boogie on. So, and that was $8, I think.
Yeah.
So, lunch total with those was closer to $50. I think it was $56 something. But our food portion was only like $24, $27 something.
And the prices on the food really wasn't that unreasonable.
So, mine was $10.99 for a foot-long hot dog. And I was expecting a foot-long regular skinny
Oscar Mayer looking.
It was a foot long all beef Nathan's hot dog.
It was huge. Ginormous.
I ate half of it. Not even. A little bit less than half.
Yeah.
And no fries. And I was super full.
It was like a kielbasa on a bun.
Yeah, it was huge.
Huge.
Yeah. So lunch was good. And then after lunch, we stayed in Tomorrowland for quite a while. We did the teacups. We went on Buzz Lightyear. We went on the Fast Track.
Yep. The Fast Track Speedway.
And then we did Space Mountain. That one said 35-minute wait, and it was true to time. It was 35 minutes. That line, even spaced out the way we were every 6 feet, it took 35 minutes. Which still is, compared to normal Disney World wait times, if you've ever seen them before COVID, 300 minutes, 400 minutes, even up to, I've seen 500 minutes on Space Mountain. I'll wait 35. I'm like, I'm good.
Well, and so a lot of it too, like, so you know they have the fast pass lanes and the stuff. They'll have two lanes and one will go to one ride and one will go to the other. They were splitting people up. So you go in and they go, okay, so how many? Two? Okay, so you're going to go this way. Okay, so you
that
have
was on
five.
A couple different rides.
Go over this way.
That.
And they were to get
were
people moving
to,
through fast.
And it really wasn't that bad of a wait, except Space Mountain doesn't have that much of stuff in the queue. Like, there wasn't that much to look at. It was pretty
There was
boring.
Weird stuff to look at, but it wasn't interactive or anything you could really read. It was the same thing.
Buzz Lightyear ride? I kicked his butt. was saying. He let me win because he knows I'm a horrible loser. So that's how sweet he is. He loves me.
I saw she was behind, so I backed off a little bit on.
It's all right. I still won.
She still won.
The end.
I was trying at the end. I was like, I need to catch up and close this gap.
Oh, stop it. That's funny. You're hilarious. It was super fun ride. I love that one. It's a Space Ranger spin, and you shoot at the aliens with laser guns, and it keeps track of your points.
And you got a little thing where you can spin the cart.
Spin the cart around, so because there's stuff on both sides. It was so much fun. I would totally do that one over and over. I had a lot of fun. But after we got off the teacups, it started raining. Well, while we were on the teacups, it started raining and thundering.
We were excited. Because it was so hot.
Like, we were really, like, overheated a little bit towards the end of the day wearing the masks. And we bought some really super cute masks. And we'll show you guys. But I got a cute Halloween Disney mask that says Boo on it with some Disney treats and stuff. And then we also got some Universal masks, Universal Studios Hollywood Horror Nights masks. So we had really nice masks. They're really hot and sweaty. And yeah, I didn't like that.
We wore the standard thin medical looking.
Yeah, the blue and white masks.
And they were still hot, but they were easier to breathe in.
Much easier to breathe. And it was nice when we did get wet, like on Splash Mountain. It kept you a little bit cooler, which was nice. A lot of the queues are air conditioned partially. Like, you go in, get a little air conditioning, and then you walk out. And then you go in, get a little air conditioning, and then you walk out. But so you got a break that way. I could see how sometimes in a longer line that might be beneficial. Our lines moved so fast, we didn't really get to enjoy it. I'm not complaining at all that short lines were nice. But air conditioning would have been a little bit nice. They had relaxation stations all over. So a lot of the closed restaurants opened up their areas, tables and chairs. You could go in there, take your mask off, sit. In order to take your mask off, you have to be in one spot, either sitting or standing, away from other people, and eating or drinking. The relaxation stations, you don't have to be eating or drinking. You can go in, sit down, take your mask off, you're good. But they patrolled that. We did every once in a while towards the end of the day when we were really getting overheated, we would be standing in line because we saw everyone else doing it. We're going to take a drink of water. And we take our mask off really quick, take a drink, and put our mask back on. But you have to in the Florida heat. Granted, it was September. It was still hot. It was 87 on Saturday when we got there. I don't know what it was on Sunday. It had to have been at least 90. That part wasn't awful, but it really got to us towards the end of the day. When it started raining, we got off the teacups, and Seven Dwarfs Mine Train was literally right there. The line, super long. It was a 50-minute wait, it said. But as soon as it started thunder and lightning, shut it down.
Yep.
It's a tall ride. You obviously you're not gonna have that running for safety concerns. It was lightning within 4 miles. We stood in line for a while hoping it would blow over. We did bring ponchos. We didn't take them out because it wasn't really raining that hard.
Yeah.
But it was lightning and thundering like crazy. After about 20 minutes,
we went and did the Winnie the Pooh ride.
We decided to go across from there and went in to the Winnie the Pooh. Because if it's an inside ride, they don't stop those, obviously, for rain and lightning and thunder. And we thought, oh, perfect opportunity. We'll see. Hopefully, maybe it'll be done by the time we get out of there and we can go get in line again. We got out of there. It was still sprinkling, but the line was even longer. Because I think everyone was hoping, but it was still shut down. So we decided, obviously, it's not going to be a ride we get to do this time. and headed towards the President's Hall of Presidents. Well,
no, we did the Little Mermaid.
Oh, we did the Little Mermaid first. That was right there.
And we got a story for Little Mermaid. I might have a video that I'll play here real quick.
Oh, yeah. So, you go ahead. You tell it. This was your favorite part.
So, we were in the line, and the line was moving fairly quick, and then you get in, and there's the seagull, and he's talking about all the little doodads the crabs are bringing out and stuff. And we stood there.
It's pretty entertaining.
It is. And we stood there for quite a while, and I'm like thinking to myself, this is... The line was moving fast, and now we're at a standstill. And then it finally, after 5 minutes, it picked back up, and we moved through, and we got on. We go through, and right after you come down and turn the corner, Ariel's sitting there singing about having doodads and walking through... And the ride stops.
We're stuck. Listening to Ariel sing the same little...
Snippet of a song.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain seated in your vehicle. Your ride of vehicle may resume motion at any time. Thank you so much.
While I get to the bottom of this.
So I took some video of it and some pictures.
I was just glad we weren't two clamshells down, because they were only filling every other two clamshells down. They were literally in the little dark cave right in between the two scenes, staring at a wall. So I was like, I get to see Ariel and Sebastian and Flounder. I was okay with it.
And it was down for probably about 5 minutes. So we got to sit in some air conditioning for about five minutes.
That was nice too.
And then we started looking, and we were like, oh, we can see Sebastian. Like, he's popping up here and he's popping over here.
Yeah, we get to see a lot of stuff you normally probably would miss just going by.
And then
it started up again.
And then you go through, and they're doing the...
Under the sea,
and then it stopped again.
And we sat there again.
But it was only, like, for maybe a minute, yeah.
Yeah.
And then it started up, and then it made it through finally. So I'm like, I'm thinking maybe it broke down before, and that's why we got stranded there watching the seagull and the crabs.
Yeah. And the line waiting. It was hilarious, I have to say. So after Ariel, it was still raining. We got out. It had...
And the line for the mine carts was wrapped all the way around the ride.
It was up to 60-minute wait, and still not going yet. They still hadn't even started it yet, because it was still lightning and thunder in the area. So we're like, yep, we're going down to Liberty Square, because he really wanted to see the Hall of Presidents presentation. And I thought, perfect timing, you know, because it's raining and whatever.
Oh, on our way there, we did the Philhar Mickey.
Oh, the Philhar Magic.
Or Philhar Magic.
Yeah, Mickey's Philhar Magic. That was cool.
It was cool, yeah. It was a 4D experience.
It was a 20-minute show?
It was about a 20-minute show.
20 minutes. And it was just cool.
Yeah, it was...
It's hard to explain, but it's like a lot of music. And it's like Sorcerer Mickey and Donald steals his hat. And a bunch of shenanigans and different movies.
Different Disney movies and stuff. Awesome. So, yeah. It's
definitely, like, one of those when I watch other creators' videos about Disney World and Magic Kingdom. It's one of those that they're like, it's not a must-do. But if you have time, go do it. And I'm like, this was cool. I want my kids to see
this. Yeah, yeah.
It was so much fun to watch. And then Donald gets thrown behind you, and it's hilarious. It was,
and like, yeah. The Lion King is one of my favorite Disney movies, and there was a little Lion King part in there. Yeah,
that was cool.
So
yeah, I forgot about that part. That was a little bit of a wait, though. We waited 15 or 20 minutes to get in.
But
there.
It's not one of those that they can really push people through. So
we had to wait for the next show. It wasn't that big of a deal, and it's air conditioned, so we were cool, chilling in there. Then we finally made it to Hall of Presidents.
In the Hall of Presidents, we waited probably 15, 20.
That's another one. Yeah, we had to wait for the next show. It was probably 15, 20 minutes for that one too, and that's a 23-minute presentation. And it's mostly a movie.
I was expecting more president talk than what we got. But the movie was cool.
Yeah, I didn't remember that it was a movie. I thought it was more of the president's
I think they may have talking, upgraded it
but
a little bit.
I really enjoyed the actual movie video part of it.
Mm-hmm.
It was a great presentation. And then the presidents come out and introduce themselves. That was awesome. So for somebody like me who's not big into history, just putting a face with the president's name was nice. Like I said, I've seen it before. I've been there before, but I was 14. I was not paying attention to that. I'm like, I want to see dolphins at SeaWorld, and I don't care about this stuff. But now at 43, I'm like, hell yeah, let's go back. Oh, watch my mouth.
Heck yeah.
So, yeah. And then we came out of there, and there was we caught a glimpse of a parade.
Oh, it was the rainy day parade. Yeah.
That was really cute. I got some pictures of a parade too when we were looking for food, walking around by Main Street there, the rainy day parade came out. That was the princess parade by the Hall of Presidents, but I don't even think you saw it when we came out. I saw the very tail end of it.
It's weird because you can hear it off in the distance, and then when you know it's getting close, they turn on the speakers by you, so it's just blaring.
It's
loud. And you're like, wait, what's going on?
Are we going to get run over? Yeah. That's what I said. I'm like, oh, gosh. But it was cute. I got to see Tiana anyway.
And Jen really wanted Dole Whip, and we had seen it earlier, but she wanted to eat lunch. And I said, by the time the parade went by, she's like, let's go. I'm over this. I just want to go eat real food. And I said, let's go find some Dole Whip. We're close to Frontierland. Let's go find the Dole Whip.
So, and actually, we didn't even make it to Frontierland. That was still in Liberty Square.
Yeah, it was kind of like a little, the back area.
Excuse me. It's just like a little counter there, but there was no one there. Like, you could actually walk up. It wasn't the original, the OG Dole Whip that I wanted, but it was really good.
She got the Lava Sundae, which is orange Dole Whip with like a strawberry Fanta.
And what were those things?
It had pop rocks.
I couldn't think of the name of them. It was really good. And then Corey got...
I got the Headless Horseman Sundae, and it was strawberry Dole Whip with strawberry Fanta, and it was more of a float, but it had a little light-up Headless Horseman on it, and
that's
you push
you
a little button.
That's
yeah,
I
that's what
it.
I wanted, but
that's what
the,
I got
the
it.
Dole Whip was really good, so...
And while we sat, because you have to sit and eat it, right? Because I was hoping we could just eat it as we're walking out. No. Oh, crap. Yeah, we got to sit down so we can eat this. So we went straight across, and there's just like this little bench thing. Sat there, started eating. Downpour.
Luckily, we made it.
We almost finished before it started downpouring.
And then it kind of stopped.
Well, it wasn't down. I say downpour. It was starting to rain heavier than it was earlier. And big drops.
So we went through.
We're like, we're almost done. We're leaving anyway. So we didn't bother getting out the parka or the
ponchos.
Parkas. The ponchos or anything. And we just started walking really fast towards the exit. because everybody was, because it was, like I said, it was starting to rain harder. And then
we got the ferry over to the share ride pickup. Yep. And on the ferry, it started to rain a little heavier.
Even heavier, and more lightning, and more thunder.
By the time we got off the ferry, Jen had booked the Uber or Lyft while we were on the ferry, and she's like, oh my goodness, they're here. We have like two minutes to get up.
Because they'll only wait for you for 5 minutes.
So we were running in a torrential downpour.
No ponchos.
And luckily the guy had a minivan so she could scoot through. I waited in the rain. I ran up there first to hold the car, and then I let her slide across, and then I got in and we took the ride over to
Universal
City Walk, and I think we will do City Walk
on the next one.
Next video.
So watch for part 3 and have a great night.
Bye!